You like what you see? I feel some of you might be surprised to see that I completely skip entering battle in a palace. This is because in Persona 5 Royal, Ryuji's insta-kill passive that he learns at rank 7 has been buffed. Before, Ryuji's insta-kill in vanilla Persona 5 will completely kill the enemy but not earn any reward except for possibly recruiting a persona. Now, in Royal, Ryuji's passive will still net you the possibility of recruiting the persona, but you can also get the experience, money, and a chance at item drops. So it's a welcome buff to this passive with this change alone. However, the change that we can insta-kill in palaces was stumbled upon by accident as I was playing the game and got a little too overleveled in a palace. It didn't click until a moment later that you could, on paper, get Ryuji to rank 7 as early as possible and then try to obtain the largest source of experience to become overleveled to the point you just insta-kill everything, never having to enter the animation to go into battle, having to battle, and the animation for the results screen. So as I become to talk about the process of achieving this as early as possible, keep in mind that this is something I stumbled upon that can be potentially used. It might be too inconvenient or require too much setup to be viable for any usage, but this could be useful or modified by people who experiment with this feature to speedrunning, as you can potentially cut time because you can skip all the animation that happens when you enter a battle. In a casual setting, it's just a fun little mechanic to play around or to reach the newer content of the game faster. Regardless, let me show you how it's done. First, the obvious requirement is getting Ryuji to rank 7 as soon as possible. The issue of getting to rank 7 is that Ryuji only has certain days you can actually get to rank 7. I rushed trying to get to rank 7, which happened after the second palace. Maybe somebody else can get to that faster than me, but in this video I'm doing the method before the third palace. So if we achieve this, we will skip all normal battles from the third palace and onwards to the end of the game, only needing to fight required battles like bosses. Once we get to Ryuji to rank 7, we just need to get a large source of experience. The best candidate is the Reaper. Because flu season has been changed to not inflict a Reaper, we cannot rely on exploding a mechanic to get overleveled, as this would have only worked much later in the game, so this would void how useful this whole gimmick could be because of how early you can pull it off. This is where the benefit of only the new Persona and Battle Item Bundle DLC comes in handy. These two bundles are very, very strong. The Persona Bundle DLC features Izanagi-No-Okami and its Piccolo form, both being level 80 and 89 Personas respectively, with an almighty AoE attack that hits extremely hard. So this is where the issue lies at. If I just one-shot enemies of Izanagi-No-Okami, then what's the point of going through extra steps just to cut the animations? And yes, I agree. This is why I call this more of a gimmick than some exploit, because it's just a way to play the game differently and potentially speed up your playthrough, which could be useful in a speedrun, but unless tested, it's more for fun. As for the battle item bundle, the most useful items you can get there are the soul foods, which fully restore your SP, beads, which fully restore your HP, and humunculi, which are used to prevent an insta-kill from Hama and Moodle skills. Honestly, the soul foods and beads are very useful, but I would say the humunculi are what truly shine in this item bundle. The only way to get humunculi are either maxing out Takemi's confidant to unlock it in her store, or to fix the laptop you can buy when you unlock Akihabara, and shop at the shady commodity store and buy enough from there to get the opportunity to buy one humunculus per shipment. In other words, it's a late game item that you can get so early it literally will carry you fighting the Reaper of Izanagi-No-Okami because it doesn't resist, null, or absorb light and dark skills. So when you fight the Reaper of Izanagi-No-Okami, your real dangers are almighty and insta-kill skills. Being able to patch this weakness is the key to defeating the Reaper early on. Aside from that, is there anything else to help? Well, you could invest in working out. Because of the changes in Persona 5 Royal allowing you to do basic tasks at LeBlanc after story events or metaverse runs that would otherwise be nulled in vanilla Persona 5 because Morgana would tell us to go to sleep. So other than raising your social stats, you could early on work out to increase HP. Buying protein is essential because you can gain additional HP points, but this is only recommended early on. If you work out, try to save it when you unlock the gym in Shibuya, because there, after some time, will net you 11 HP and 9 SP every time you go there and use protein. The additional boost in your HP and SP is so beneficial because this means you can take more hits from the Reaper and use more skills before needing to take a turn to heal yourself. But remember, the bundle only gives you 10 humunculi. Essentially, while RNG is a big factor, you're under a timer because you can only take 10 insta-kill hits before you're open to dying from them. And the more you use up, the less you have to do more Reaper runs, and remember, you won't get any more until you unlock them from Takemi or the Shady Commodity site. You want to potentially do 2-3 runs so you're leveled high enough to reach those points in the game, but can still one-shot all the enemies in the palaces you reached up until that point. Therefore, you want to minimize the amount of turns you heal so you can be actively attacking and buffing yourself as many times to kill the Reaper as soon as possible, especially because we're doing this at a point when we don't have Gallus. And this is where I can mention that you don't have to do this early if you're not wanting to purchase the DLC. Because once you unlock Gallus, you can make your ultimate persona, as long as you have the income for it, to battle the Reaper and do the insta-kill gimmick in palaces. Since Atlas West announced all Persona 5 DLC will be free for Royal, you can build Kaguya, for example, who knows light and dark to be an efficient Reaper killer. Just remember you have to patch that weakness to fire or the Reaper will target it and it won't be a fun time. And after maxing out that magic stat, raise endurance so you can tank the hits, as the beauty of Izanagi-No-Okami Picoro is this endurance stat that will be tanking the hits since you have very bad armor early on. The importance of endurance is because of the formula the game uses to calculate damage inversely proportioned to your defenses. While the information I found is based off the damage calculations in Persona 4, and it's assumed it's the same for Persona 5, if someone can confirm or correct the calculations, that'd be reassuring to my point. The equation is the square root of defense plus 8 times your current persona's endurance stat. The endurance of your persona is very important in this current case because of how early in the game we are and the lack of options for strong armor. So this endurance is necessary, but it doesn't need to be maxed out. Just don't forget to increase it if you're using a persona that's not Izanagi-No-Okami. Now that we cleared up getting our personas ready, like I said, your armor is not going to be amazing, but your accessories could also heavily impact you. Those with the DLC bundles, good news, you have a strong accessory that boosts your HP by 40%, which is why you see my character with 698 HP because of this accessory. Don't worry, there's also other options that are very good alternatives. The other being the Invention Store in Kijijoji have an accessory you can buy with its unique currency that grants Masuku Kaja. This is what I use in the second fight that utilizes a Gallus boosted Izanagi-No-Okami to show you that you don't need a workout to beat the Reaper, but it's very good if you want to do it early before unlocking Gallus. A free Tsukukaja buff in this fight is amazing, especially if the Reaper starts to use physical or gun skills, and dodging those will mean needing to heal less and you have more opportunities to be offensive. As well, there are chances the Reaper will dodge your attack, and it's very detrimental because Izanagi-No-Okami skill uses 40 SP, which is a huge chunk of what limited SP you have early on. Don't want to miss. These two accessories I would say are your best until you get the Divine Pillar from, well, killing the Reaper first. Some additional side stuff that can help you if you're waiting until you unlock Gallus is you can utilize the new Mementos update to gather stamps and increase your experience gain from Jose. If you're doing this very early on, it's not worth since the time it's needed to gather them just to potentially see 20% more experience isn't that much, unlike later in the game when you have more stamps to collect and can increase your experience gain to a higher percentage like 50%. However, if you're not in a rush or speedrunning, this can help a little. Now, if you're ready and confident, set your difficulty to easy in case you have it at a higher difficulty, it's time to fight the Reaper. Just remember to remove your party members since they're not strong enough to handle the Reaper, and they'll just get exploded from their weakness and the Reaper will attack you with extra turns, and that means using up more of your scarce supplies. Also, good tip is to let the Reaper ambush you, because if you attack it, it will have 2 turns, versus if you get ambushed by the Reaper, it only has 1 turn. If you keep yourself nice and healed, just keep hitting at it and you'll defeat it before you use up all your resources. Repeat this as much as you possibly can with your current items, and now you're over leveled enough to clear palaces without having to fight a normal battle once. I want to mention too that this method will see a greater opportunity in New Game Plus because your compendium progress is passed on. You can just buy your Gallus boosted personas from your previous playthrough and defeat the Reaper as early as you unlock Mementos, just needing to get Ryuji to rank 7 to have this gimmick begin. Now that I'm done going over this, I want to turn it over to you watching. Do you think it's potentially useful or just a fun gimmick to try out on your playthrough? I want to see if this could be possibly useful to the community, so I welcome modifications, fixes, corrections, anything you can think that can be beneficial to smoothing this out. If not, then whatever, I thought it was a fun discovery. If you have any questions, let me know down below, and until the next video, stay salty and healthy, everyone.